Hey, my name is Homar Perez. I'm from Corona, California, and I'm here at the Paris Raceway doing a Swapmoto Race Series. What motocross means to my family is, well, you see, my dad never rode a dirt bike. He's only seen them on magazines, the Transworld magazines when they used to be sold back in 7-Eleven. He's always talked to me about how he always wanted to ride a dirt bike when he was little, never had the opportunity. I turned 6 years old. And then I told my dad, I want to use that Honda. I take it out to this little dirt patch that we have in front of our house. I use it, and then that's where I fell in love with motocross. Just the feel of the bike sliding on a corner, the feel of everything. And then we always did desert riding, we always did trail riding, but then we saw a track, it was Milestone. We went out there, oh my gosh, my love of motocross increase by 10 times. The feel of first time ever jumping, the feel of the wind when I was mid-air, brushing everything up against, I truly fell in love with motocross at Milestone. So sad to see you go. When I did my first race, back when Transworld was still alive, it was exciting. It was brand new. Every time when I think about it, I keep thinking to myself how nervous I was, how anxious, how I got so nervous, I even got stuck on the gate. I really got inspired by motocross. I really got the chance to do it only because of my dad. You see, my dad works Monday through Saturday. He will always get up at 6 in the morning and always come home at 4 p.m. I've gone to work with him. I've seen how hard he works. I've seen the blisters on his hands. I've seen how hard he sweats. I see how much effort he puts into it. Also, I can have good bikes, good gear, good everything. He does this all for his son, for me, and I am so grateful for that. I know there are some kids out there that don't have the opportunity to ride. And honestly, sometimes when I even think about it, I get a little bit emotional, but my dad, he lived in Mexico almost all of his childhood, came home, came here to the United States as an immigrant, got his green card, and he worked his ass off to pay off for each single bike. He always tells me, you know how much money I spent on your dirt bikes, on your gear, on everything? I could have paid off my mortgage to the house already. I know, and I'm so grateful for that. There are some times where we do struggle, but I know he's always there for me, and he brings me every Wednesday and Sunday to the track. as soon as he gets home from Wednesday night, we come here to Paris night. I either come home from school and he's not there and I load up the stuff. If I'm not home early, he loads up everything. So he gets home from work at 2. He comes home early on Wednesdays just for me. And then he comes late, even later on Thursday nights. But he comes home all tired, all dirty and sweaty, doesn't take a shower. He doesn't care about his appearance. He comes in comes in all tired, loads up all the bike and everything, waits for me to get home. Then we head out to Paris. He sticks it out with me. he sees me ride. He sees me trying. He's there for me. He's there telling me, oh, you should work on this, you should work on that. Do I pay attention sometimes? Maybe not, but that's not the point. He's always there for me. He does not care if he's tired or nothing. And I am truly grateful for that. Do I know any friends that race or friends from the track? Of course I do. I always try to make new friends. To the person parked next to me, I always try to say, hey, my name is Omar, nice to meet you. I have a couple friends in particular that are now my best friends. His name is Brandon Medina. I always confuse his name. Sorry, Brandon. he's my best friend. I met him at a race. I remember how every single night we will FaceTime, we'll be talking about moto, we'll be talking about strategies, we'll be talking about how to improve our riding. Honestly, I've seen some friends come and go. I used to have a huge group of motocross friends, but now they hardly ever ride. But I still see them once and now and then. But truly, motocross has made me closer to one particular friend, and that's Brandon.